Hey everybody, it's Mr. Smedes, and today I'm going to be reacting to this new Chipotle short film in support of small farming communities. It's called The Future Begins. Now, I know you guys usually come here for FRQ advice or for notes videos or because your teacher makes you, but one of my favorite things about teaching apes is just how applicable the content we learn is to your everyday life. So the sustainable farming concepts you'll learn about in Unit 5, almost all of them appear in this 2.5 minute short film by Chipotle, kind of this animated, heartwarming story of a son going off to college, the struggles the family farm faces. Oh, and by the way, Casey Musgrave does the soundtrack, so there's that too.
When you try your best, but you don't succeed. When you get what you want, but not what you need.
All right, so right off the bat here, we have so many great apes concepts at work. First of all, he's got his bike on top of the car when he's going to college, so you know he's going to be a zero emissions commuter once he gets there. Then we have dad who's planting his little tomatoes, and he looks like he's using a rototiller to spread his seeds. In the background, we have what looks like monocropping. So we've got this huge farm that's just dousing their fields with some sort of purple chemical. Given that it looks like it's kind of being sprayed, it's probably a pesticide. And then dad here even looks like he might be doing some rotation of his fields or some sort of rotational grazing. So it looks like he's going to move the cows from one pasture to another. We can even see the pasture kind of on the top of the screen here on the other side of the fence is kind of lush and green. It's had time to recover, whereas the pasture on the bottom half is looking like the grass has maybe been compacted too far. It looks like even maybe desertification might be, you know, in its beginning stages, as we have a lot of exposed soil, grass that's been chewed down too far. So subtle attention to detail by the artist who did this, really neat.
And the tears come streaming down your face. When you lose something you can't replace. Could it be worse?
Oh no, so we have dad going down here in the 5 foot snowdrift. So the other thing that's kind of funny about this is we can clearly tell this is in the Midwest, right? Like nowhere else gets dumped on with snow that drifts over your head. So yeah, dad gets hurt, he falls down, and it looks like they're gonna have to put the farm up for sale, you know, and this is kind of the stark reality of just the like razor thin margins that a lot of family farms operate on. Meanwhile, you have the son off at college. He's learning about like new irrigation techniques. He sees all of these practices in his classes. And, you know, I'm hoping that we can see some of that come into play here when he comes back home.
Lights will guide you home.
And just like that, the farm is saved. The son sees a picture of he and his dad as a kid, puts on his blue cap, comes back from college with all his new knowledge. So right here, we see a great example of something that in apes we call polyculture, and that's planting numerous different species of plants. It's gonna allow you to harvest at different times, potentially even do some crop rotation. It's not gonna deplete the soil of all the same nutrients. And so a great agricultural practice here that we can review. Now, we do have to talk about the fact that not all these crops are ready to harvest at the same time, but we're gonna cut Chipotle a little slack on that one.
I will try to fix you.
All right, I love it. They're bringing in solar panels, so we're going zero carbon emissions here on the electricity for the farm. They've planted windbreaks, so all of these trees that are on the edges of their fields, not only does it look like maybe they're even providing fruit, but they're going to stop some of the wind from blowing across their field. So they're gonna hopefully reduce some topsoil erosion. And it looks like they're even getting ready to change out what they're planting here. All right, and there it is. They hit you with like every sustainable farming practice in the book. So we've got intercropping. We have, you know, different species being planted right next to each other. Again, kind of changing the nutrient profiles that they need from the soil. Can also be used as a form of integrated pest management. Maybe some of those crops are a natural habitat for predators of some of the pests on their farm. We can see in the background, it looks like there's even terracing. So they're kind of cutting, you know, flat ledges into these hills to reduce runoff and to reduce erosion from the slope of the hills. It looks again like they're using windbreaks on the edge of the field to try to prevent the wind and the rain from eroding topsoil. It looks like they're even doing contour plowing maybe, so kind of plowing with the contours of the land, again, to try to reduce soil runoff. So props to Chipotle for squeezing every sustainable farming practice in the Apes curriculum into like 30 seconds of this beautifully animated little film here. And there you have it, pesticide-free produce for Chipotle burritos, the salvation of the family farm, passage on of the farming tradition to the next family generation. It's a tall task and a 2-minute short film, but Chipotle seems to have pulled it off here. Now, we don't want to gloss over the fact that all of these practices are costly to install, take time, the weather doesn't always cooperate, right, quite the way we saw. But all in all, I think it's a pretty heartwarming tale and an inspiring message. Now, we do need to pump the brakes here a little bit and ask ourselves some bigger long-term questions, like what percentage of all of their ingredients is Chipotle sourcing from small sustainable farming communities like this one beautifully portrayed here? You know, is their meat coming from large CAFOs? Is it coming more from small farmers or, you know, rotational grazing type of operations? So a lot of questions here, but to their credit, Chipotle is investing money in both rural seed banks and rural farmer education programs. So they are putting some of their money where their mouth is, and I think they deserve some credit for that. So the next time you sink your teeth into a Chipotle burrito, pause for a second and think about both the apes concepts and the sustainable farming practices or not sustainable farming practices that might have led to those ingredients. I can't promise that it'll make the burrito taste any better, but I can tell you it will certainly help you out on your Unit 5 Apes test. As always, think like a mountain, write like a scholar.